Hello, welcome back. Welcome to this fourth video of this of the series. As you know, I'm currently designing and building a tube stereo receiver, which will include an FM tuner, a Bluetooth receiver, and a digital to analog converter as well. All that will fit into a compact, I believe, chassis. Much progress was achieved in the last weeks. As you will see in the video, I began working on the core part of the tube stereo receiver, which is the tube power section, power amplifier section, and preamplifier, tube preamplifier as well. Also, you will see I completed the power supply modules. So, having said that, let's give a look at the current progress. Thank you very much. This is a global view of the back of the new amplifier. As you can see, the rear panel is completed. You have seen already in the last videos, but now we have the new digital optical input here, and the antenna and the Bluetooth antenna as well. So the rear panel is completed now. And this is a global view of how the amplifier will look like from the front. I installed the power tube and the preamplifier tubes. I didn't switch on for the first time. So I didn't test, I didn't adjust the bias, the settings. I think I'm pretty close to that moment. But yeah, anyway, in the meantime, this is just to have an idea of how the amplifier will look like. As you can see, here we have the four power tubes. These are Russian 6P3CE, so the E version is the more robust one. These are the two phase splitters, this one and this one, for the left channel and the right channel. These are ECC81. These are the power amplifier first gain stages. So these are EF86 tubes. And these are the two preamplifier tubes. These are two ECC83 double triode tubes for the preamplifier section. As I said before, I think I'm pretty close to the moment when I will be able to test the audio section, the tube preamplifier and tube power amplifier, first tube power amplifier section. So, approaching that moment, I need to get prepared. So, I would just like to show you the setup which I will be using in order to properly test the performances of the tube amplifier. Now the setup is not connected to the tube amplifier, so it's just to show you how I will be testing. Of course, the first part, the first instrument will be a signal generator. In this moment it is generating a sine wave of 1 kHz. The signal generator will be used to feed a signal into the tube amplifier. And then I will be using the distortion meter and the oscilloscope in order to check the specifications of the signal coming out from the tube amplifier. This is a very reliable, old reliable distortion meter. In this moment it is of course measuring just the distortion coming out from the signal generator. It is very low, it is 0.01, so it's very good. But again, as I said, this is not connected to the amplifier. And the oscilloscope is of course showing just the sine wave generated by the signal generator. I will be using this setup in order to properly measure all the specifications, all the characteristics of the audio signal coming out from my tube amplifier. For example, distortion, pass band. Also, I will be feeding a square wave in order to check for any instability, any ringing. So Yeah, of course, it will be very important to carefully check each and every specification of the new amplifier. Here you can see the amplifier in upside down position. Of course, this is the most convenient position in order for me to work on the electronics. And in particular, you can see the power supply module. You might remember this. This is almost completed, just some connection to be finalized. You might remember the aluminium chassis, which is then currently installed in vertical position. So this is the high voltage section. This is the first part of the bias power supply section. This is the second part and final part of the bias supply section. You might see the four trimmers. Through those, I can adjust the polarization voltage applied to each one of the four power tubes. This is the transformer, we saw that last in the last video, feeding the bias power supply. And this is the another transformer. This is the first power supply module I built, feeding Arduino. Then this is a power resistor belonging to the high voltage section. You might also see a part of this integrated circuit. This is a 7806 stabilizer integrated circuit, which generates 6 volt stabilized DC for the preamplifier tubes heaters. This integrated circuit, as well as many others which we cannot see from here, from this position, this integrated circuit is directly mounted on the aluminium chassis for better cooling. Finally, you might notice this in the background, this piece of solid copper. This is the star grounding point. This is very important in order to minimize the noise. In particular, I'm speaking about the 50 hertz or 100 hertz noise, which is called hum. In order to minimize that, it's very important that each and every grounding wire coming from all over the circuit is connected at the same point. And again, this is the point which collects all the groundings. This is again a very effective. I have found that this is very effective for sake of reducing the hum to a minimum. I would like to give you an idea now about how the different modules will be installed. You might find it a little bit of a mess, but trust me, it's not. I mean, maybe now it's a mess, but at the end, everything will find its place within the chassis. You will sure remember this module. This is the FM tuner module. Also, this one we described previously. This is Arduino with the two relevant displays. This is the digital to analog converter module. This is still to be designed. Well, it is already almost 90% designed. I just need to build. And this is the Bluetooth module. This is let's say the digital sources part, and this is the FM tuner, the analog FM tuner part. So as you can see, each module is mounted on an aluminium chassis. So these two parts will be installed exactly in this position. You can you should imagine too that those two parts will slide here inside the chassis, more or less at half eighth of the main chassis. So pretty exciting, I believe. I hope it's the same for you. I think I'm close to testing at least one channel, one tube power amplifier channel, and this will be subject of next video. In the meantime, thank you very much for your attention, and yeah, see you in the next video. Thank you very much. Bye.